Life can exist almost anywhere. As conditions on Earth change, life changes. Every plant and animal species alive today is alive because it has adapted. It has changed in order to survive in an environment. Plants and animals adapt for two reasons: to defend themselves and to get food. The wolf kills and eats other animals. Its teeth are long, sharp, adapted for attacking prey and tearing flesh. Survive in their environment. The arrow leaf can grow in two environments, on land or in water, and still get its nutrients. Arrow leaf plants growing on land have leaves that stand erect to get the maximum amount of sunlight. The root structure is well developed, and nutrients are obtained from the soil. Arrow leaf plants that grow in water have leaves that have adapted to get nutrients directly from the water in which they live. Very different adaptations are needed to survive in this environment. In the desert, the sun bakes the rocks and dry sands. It almost never rains. Here, the loose, shifting sands make movement difficult. The sidewinder rattlesnake has developed a sideways progression. It shifts its weight to its head and tail and rolls the rest of its body forward. An adaptation, a response to the sandy environment. To protect itself from the intense heat, the sidewinder can bury itself in the sand. Horn-like structures above the eyes block out the sun. Pits on each side of the snake's head are sensitive to the body heat of other animals. This is how the sidewinder locates its prey. In parts of the desert, cactus can exist because they have adapted. Their leaves are reduced to spines. These and the waxy surface of the plants reduce water loss, resist shrinkage, and discourage feeding animals. Many desert plants are succulents. They store water for future use. The Gila monster stores food. In the desert, food is often scarce. When food is plentiful, the Gila monster stores fat in its tail. When the food supply is low, this adaptation enables the Gila monster to live off this reserve until the time when food is again available. Gray whales are huge mammals, 50 feet long. They swim from the frozen Arctic 6,000 miles to a place halfway around the world, A journey of 8 months. During that time, they do not eat. How do they survive? Like the Gila monster, gray whales live off food stored as fat. Finally, they reach the warm waters off Mexico, where their calves are born and can survive. Adaptation. The sea also provides food for this animal, the polar bear. Its world is a frozen wasteland, a place of ice and snow. Food is scarce, and with the passing of time, the polar bear has adapted, changed in order to survive. It is a strong swimmer. Its thick fur and layer of body fat protect it from the icy waters. The polar bear has adapted so that it gets its food where it can find it, from the sea. There are animals that have adapted to live in the almost total darkness of caves. When an animal does not use an organ, eventually it often ceases to function. These animals are almost totally blind. Bats sleep throughout the day. At night, they leave their caves in search of food. How do they find it? They locate their food by sound, sonar. Following echoes reflected off the body of its prey, the bat tracks it down. Plants and animals adapt for two reasons: to get food and to defend themselves. In the natural balance of eat or be eaten, competition is fierce, conditions often harsh. Life forms that cannot defend themselves do not survive. Some milkweeds are poisonous. The monarch butterfly can eat them and not be harmed. But if a bird eats the monarch butterfly, it becomes sick. This viceroy butterfly looks very similar to the monarch. In time, birds began to avoid the viceroy too. Like the viceroy, many organisms demonstrate mimicry. They have adapted an appearance that protects them. The chameleon is able to blend in with its surroundings. This is camouflage, an adaptation that helps prevent its being seen by enemies. The chameleon often changes color according to its moods. When winter brings snow, the snowshoe rabbit uses camouflage. So does the ptarmigan. It changes with the seasons. Camouflage, an adaptation used by many organisms. The mountains. Often a cold, windy environment. Plants have adapted to it by growing in clumps, producing within their own microclimate of warmth. In cold areas, the soil is thin and shifting. To survive here, grasses and shrubs weave their roots around the soil particles. Other plants, such as mosses, cling to the soil by means of hair-like structures. And in turn, the moss provides a bed for larger flowering plants. In a place where there is little soil, these plants have adapted. Of deciduous trees are damaged by winter conditions, making it impossible for the tree to carry on its photosynthetic and growth processes. So the tree sheds its leaves and growth stops until the spring, when the tree grows new leaves. Plants in the sea are adapted to salt water. Is this a plant? The sea anemone is an animal. It catches fish by stinging them with its poisonous tentacles. The clownfish, because of its bright color, is an easy target. But it can hide from its enemies among the anemone's tentacles. It has adapted. It is not harmed by the tentacles. In return, the clownfish massages the anemone and sometimes brings it food. This fish's adaptation? When disturbed, pufferfish will swallow water and puff up so large that they are difficult to swallow. If species cannot adapt, they do not survive. These species' habitats have been drastically changed by man. They are finding it difficult to adapt to these changes. They are endangered species. Species that, because they cannot adapt, may be on the way to extinction. It lived here millions of years ago. Could a dinosaur be found here today? It is thought that changes occurred in the dinosaur's environment, changes to which the dinosaur could not adapt. If a species cannot adapt, it dies. Dinosaurs are extinct. But did some dinosaurs adapt? Do you think it is possible, as some scientists believe, that birds are the direct descendants of dinosaurs? Adaptation.